ladies and gentlemen, welcome to tonight's matchup between the Kent State Golden Flashes and the Akron Zips. Tonight is Kent State's senior night, and Kent State has plenty of seniors in the lineup. Total of 9 seniors for Kent State, including all 3 of their goalies, CJ Coyne, who's starting in net tonight, Kevin Beauvert, and Bailey Hammonds, as both teams get set for the opening faceoff. Opening faceoff won by the Zips. It's Manarillo passing it across to his defensive partner. Kent State fights for possession there. Held in there and a drive towards the net by Nico Negron, one of the seniors, gets there and it ends up out of play. Other seniors for the Flashes tonight: Jordan Urenius, Giovanni Stelovat, Travis Sippel, Ben Bloomquist, the aforementioned Nico Negron, and Alex Sanchez. Alex Sanchez, the leading scorer for Kent State this year, with 43 points at almost 2 points per game. Meanwhile, Akron U wins the face-off in the defensive zone and pitchforks it all the way out to the neutral zone. Ends up needing Coyne to play it. Taken away by Kent State, thrown in deep by Van Cycle. Chasing after it there briefly was Meyer, but Akron U holds possession. And Kantner will drive that back deep in. As there's a battle for a puck deep in the corner, taken away by Akron. Trying to advance the play here is Akron U. Crossing the line almost offside there was Renjiak. Renjiak gets all the way behind the net before dropping it off for Rink. Battle for the play there. Good physicality by Stelovat. As Kent State takes the puck away and looks to break it out, but that's held in there at the line by Bujiak. Flashes regain possession, trying to pitchfork that back out into the neutral zone was Negron, but it goes out of play into the Kent State bench. Well, just under 2 minutes gone here in the first period. So far, no real opportunities by either team, but started play more in Akron's zone, and now we've kind of migrated down into Kent State's zone as the Flashes win the faceoff. Puck gets back for Sippel, who tries to advance it up the play there. He does. Sippel gets it up for Supek. Supek firing a shot. That's gloved down and held on by Hughes. Deceptively quick shot there by Gavin Supek, but the left glove hand of Hughes up to the task. Face-off won again by the Flashes, trying to center it there off the face-off was Dovenbagger, but he's not capable of it. Fight for the puck in the Zamboni door corner. 2 Flashes, 3 Zips. And the Zips will come out with it, wrapping that around the net and getting it all the way out to the opposite side zone for an icing was Yeast. Oh, little attempt there by Thomas to get off the ice is caught by the linesman, and he's forced back out on the ice. D3 ACHA rules. Team ices the puck, they got to keep the same line out. Kent State will look to capitalize this. Firing a shot there wide was the right winger. Tries to center a pass there for Sanchez. He can't quite get there. But Sanchez fights for the puck in the corner on the left side, and he comes out with it. Sanchez firing a shot. Stopped by Hughes. Rebounds loose. Oh, trying to get out in front there was Volker, but he couldn't backhand it past him. Zips managed to clear the puck out in the neutral zone, but Kent State takes it right back and goes back in. Meyer gives up possession. Zips start to come the other way. Lustig manages to tap that one back in Kent's ways. Meyer below the net now. Meyer circles back up and backhands it deep. Volker looking for something there, but he's hit up and taken back away by the Zips. Gets it up ahead for Thomas. Backhanded in deep there by Boehm. But Kent is able to regain possession of the puck and take it back the other way. Amory able to stick that down out of midair and retake it for the Zips. Long range shot by Boehm. That's stopped and held on to by Coyne. First real action of the game there by Coyne. Pretty easy stop there. Stayed on the ice. Rather slow shot. Just had to track it there. Face off one there by the Zips. Amory chases it deep into the corner. Amory gets shoved down there by the defending Flashes as the puck's taken away by Ambach. Ambach lays it up on ahead for Dreese, but Dreese gets knocked down. Zips take the puck away and knock it back in deep. But Ambach takes it back and starts to head it back the other way. Pitchforked out of the air and stolen by the Zips. That was Nolan Lyle. But Kent State manages to regain possession once again. Trying to take it the other way, but the Zips throw it back in deep. And looks like Golden Flashes will ice the puck. Another attempt to make a line change on an icing, this time by Giovanni Stellabot. Again, caught by the linesman. Face off won by the Zips. Going in after there was Rink, stolen away in front of the net by the Flashes, but Rink manages to get it back and throw it in deep once more. The Zips have done a good job so far at keeping the puck in the zone, but not a whole lot of pressure on the Flashes. They're just having a hard time breaking it out so far. Puck comes out in front, though. Backhand shot there. That's stopped by Coyne. Alex Renjiak was up there in front. Crosses the blue paint for a backhanded shot, but Coyne's still up to the task and stops that. Able to pressure it out of the defensive zone there was Corlew. And almost gets it up ahead for Dreese, but Dreese has it knocked off his stick, and the Zips are capable of regaining the puck and resetting behind their own net. Puck dropped off ahead there. Zips throw it out in the neutral zone. A little too far. Icing on the play. Linesman forcing the reversal of the line change there by the Zips as they ice the puck. For the third time tonight, some players are dragged off the bench and back onto the ice. Face-off won by the Flashes. Gets out in front. A rebound is loose. And what a diving save there by Hughes. Flashes hold possession. It's Sipple with a long-range shot that's blocked in traffic. Zips take it away. Back to Sipple on the blue line. Sipple dumps it back in deep. Down low for Volker. Volker tries to center it. Not there. Taken away by the Zips. Held in. Firing a long-range shot there. Was Sanchez, but it glanced off the shoulder of Volker and goes wide. Stays in play. Volker looking for Sanchez. Sanchez is tied up. He can't get a shot away. Zips take it away. Good move there in front by Wilson. Wilson's got some room. Wilson fires, scores! Great offensive pressure there by Kent State, but Wilson for Akron U manages to get the puck, steal it away, and he turns on the Jets, makes some room for himself, and fires a shot, 5-hole, that gets past Coyne. The Zips take the lead 1-0 with 13:45 to go here in the first period. Pretty large crowd in attendance here for senior night, but Akron U did a good job of silencing them so far. Face-off won by the Zips, taken away by the Flashes. Thrown back deep into the zone by Sanchez. And it's chased down by Kantner. Taken back away by the Zips. Bruno has it. Lays it up on ahead. Breaking in there was Grasha. Grasha gets it down for Thomas. Thomas out in front for ball. Finds a shot. He scores. Definitely not the start to the senior night that Kent State was looking for, as Brandon Boehm fires a beautiful shot. Bounces off the posts and in. Not really much of a chance there for Coyne. He had bodies in front. And a perfectly placed shot puts Akron up 2-0. 13-13 to go here. 2 goals in 22 seconds. Face off again, won by the Zips. Taken away, though. Long range shot there by Andrew Dreese. That was knocked into the net off the whistle, but the refs immediately wave it down. Flash's crowd gets excited for nothing. And then expresses their displeasure at the call, but the play had been blown dead. Hughes had it and let it go, but unfortunately the play was blown dead prior to the puck entering the net. Getting just outside of the line there was Supek, who fired a shot, but it bounced off the head of Corlew offside.
Thomas from Russia and Bruno at 6:47 of the first period.
Kent State looking for a response here after going down 2-0 early. Zips win the faceoff. It's Wilson. Wilson fires it all the way up, looking ahead for Amory, but it's an icing. Good break there for the Flashes. Face off in the offensive zone, won by the Flashes. It's Folker. Drops it off for Sipple. Sipple looks for a long-range shot. That doesn't get through traffic. Below the net is Sanchez. Has it poked off his stick by Buzziak. And now he's fighting in the left corner for it. Gets out for a long-range slap shot there on the left side by Blomqvist, but he's not able to get it on net. Flashes dump it back in deep. Folker to chase. Looking to center the puck out, but that's stolen away by the Flashes, or the Zips, sorry. But they put it all the way down for an icing once again. The Flashes have had no shortage of pressure and chances so far this game. They just haven't been able to capitalize on it. And going down 2-0 early, they've got their work cut out for them, but we've seen tenacity from the Flashes before. We'll see if we can see some more of that. Puck gets out to Sipple on the blue line. Sipple fires it. Gets it out in front. Good stick work there by Buzziak to block the shot attempt by Steffel. Steffel with a good hit there. Tries to stymie up the Zips, but it's not capable of it. As good defensive stick work there by Blomqvist is able to stop a streaking Amory. Long range shot attempt there by Negron, but it's taken away. Amory has it now. Amory shovels it in. Loses his stick in the process. Taken back by Sipple and the Flashes. Dropped off for Supek. Supek lays it up on ahead for Kantner, who puts it out into the neutral zone. Zips will collect it in their own zone, try to reset there. And trying to get ahead for the pass was Gavin, but he couldn't get there, so it's another icing on Akron. The multiple icings by Akron early in this game, not even halfway through the first period, and they've iced it 4 or 5 times now already. It's a bit of a testament to Kent State's tenacity and offensive pressure, but still nothing to show for it so far. As Flashes win the faceoff, good shot there. Looking for a corner was Dreese, but it goes just wide. Dreese wheels around, fires another shot again, just wide. Gets out for Van Cycle. Van Cycle firing a shot, sticked away by Hughes. Down low fighting for that puck is Corlew. Fighting against Buzziak. Getting out in front there for a shot opportunity was Dreese, but that's stopped by Hughes. point-blank range. Flash has managed to hold it in. Now coming in from the blue line and curling all the way around is Lustig. Lustig gets it out for Van Cycle. Van Cycle throws it back in. Sanchez catches it on the left side boards. Sanchez harassed by Amory, but it gets down in front for Corlew, who looks for a centering pass that's blocked away as the zip's clear. Van Cycle tries to get something there, but he can't. And Gavin tries to take it away before the Flashes take it back the other way. Lustig just crosses the red line and tries to dump it back in before it's recollected by the Zips. Gets back out to Lustig. Lustig does the same and dumps it in deep successfully this time. Taken by Boehm. Passed up to Gavin. Gavin tries to lay it up on ahead, but it bounces off the stick of Stellabot. And Wilson's able to chase it down in the offensive zone for Akron. Turns and fires a shot that goes into a skate and bounces off harmlessly wide. Volker takes it up in the neutral zone now, taken back away by the Zips, as Boehm is dumped down hard there by Stellabot, which enables the Flashes and Meyer to take it the other way. Meyer's taken down, and there's a penalty coming to Akron. Thomas is going to the box for tripping, and we'll get our first look. First look at the Kent State power play here. Not a productive power play so far this season, 13.6%. Not an ideal power play as it's immediately cleared down by Akron. Team leader is Volker with three power play goals over the course of this season. They'll look to capitalize on this man advantage as it gets up ahead to Sipple. Sipple lays it on there for Negron, who gets it in deep. Steffel will chase, Sipple will collect. Forcing it back where the Zips, but Steffel manages to knock it out of the air and hold it. Blomqvist here at the far end. Blomqvist tries to fire a shot that's blocked by Bujiak, and the Zips will clear again. Coin out of his net to slow the puck. Leaves it off for Blomqvist. Blomqvist leaves it there for Meyer, who takes it back the other way. Meyer gets past one man. Meyer's got speed. Meyer is in. Meyer goes around the net. Back out. Briefly loses the puck. Recollects it at the blue line. Drops it off there for Lustig. Lustig fires a shot that's stopped and held by Hughes. Just over a minute into this first power play for Kent State. Nothing spectacular in terms of chances, but gotten a couple shots off. Flashes win this face-off. Gets out for Sanchez. Sanchez fakes the shot, drops it off for Lustig. Lustig's in, fires a shot. That goes off a body. Bujiak manages to clear, but Sanchez gloves it down and lays it back up on ahead. As it gets back down to Sanchez, good defensive work there by Lyle. Sanchez will take it across the line himself, looking for his opportunities on the left side. Sanchez drops it back for Meyer. Meyer fires a shot, redirected in front and goes wide. Taken back away by Dreese. Dreese fakes a lacrosse move. Backs up, fires a shot, that's just high. And Thomas comes out of the box, trying to hold it in there was Lustig, but he's unsuccessful, just offside. And the Zips have killed off the penalty. 7:25 to go here in the first period. Zips still lead 2-0. Face-off taken away by the Zips, but quickly recollected by the Flashes. Dreese gets it in. Blocked up there on the stick of Gavin. Gavin lays it up on ahead for his partner, but Kent State knocks it back in. Boehm tries to advance it. Unable to collect it there was Rink, and Kent State manages to clear it back into Akron's zone. Winning the puck there is Corlew. Corlew rings it around up ahead for Negron. Negron down deep. Interfered with there was Supek. No call on the play as Corlew was forced to dump it back behind the net. Supek takes a hit there. Wins the race to the puck, though. Manages to recollect it. It bounces off his body. Hit up high there by Boehm. Still no call on the play as it gets cleared all the way out. And taken the other way by Ambach, who throws it back in deep. Boehm collects it for the Zips. Boehm backhands out into the neutral zone. Ambach knocks it right back into the Zip zone. Rink takes it. Lays it up on ahead for Gavin. Gavin will dump it in deep. No icing. Blomqvist has his opportunity to collect it and set up a breakout for the Flashes. Blomqvist leads the pass up on ahead for Kantner, who tries to center it out in front, but is taken back away by Akron. Bruno with it. Puts it up on ahead for Gasha, but Gasha can't quite get there. So Blomqvist wins the race, and there's a battle for the puck below the net. Blomqvist wins out on that one, gets it ahead for Volker, but that's held into the zone by Renjiak. Renjiak keeping it in the zone again, getting it down for Gasha, but KSU able to harass him and get the puck back. Held in there by Bujiak. As Kese clears it for a 3-on-1. Sanchez looking for Volker, and it's just behind him. Volker centers it. Blocked away by the stick of Bujiak. Taken away by Sanchez on the left side. Sanchez trying to get around the defense. Loses possession. Thomas has it now. Taken back away by Lustig. Kent State has it on the left side. Trying to put it back in. Volker shovels it in. Chased down by Dreese. Dreese still going after it. Zips hold possession. Flashes take it away and knock it back in deep. Bujiak looking up ahead, but it bounces off a skate. Taken away by the Flashes again. Supek puts it up for Dreese. Dreese dumps it. Chasing that was Corlew. Race is won by Bujiak for the Zips. Big hit there by Supek. As play's blown dead. It's coming out of the zone. Face off one there by the Flashes. Taken away by the Zips, though. Bujiak tries to clear it out, but partially blocked there by the stick of Corlew. Stymies that as Supek looks to get it up ahead for Corlew. Corlew has to chase after it. Icing waved off. Bernard has it now. Bernard looking to take it the other way. Good defensive play there by Negron to push it back in deep into Akron's zone. Left up there, Bernard takes it again. Bernard with the lead pass there, taken back away by the Flashes. Cutting into the zone is Stellabot. Stellabot behind the net. Looks over his options. Holds the puck, fires a shot, glove saved by Hughes. Just over 3 minutes to go here in the first period. After going down early 2-0, it's been all Flashes since then. And there's that tenacity we were talking about earlier in the period that we need to see from Kent State. Winning the faceoff there is the Flashes, so Steffel drops it off below the net to Negron. Negron gets it out in front back for Steffel. And that shot attempt is stopped by Hughes once again. Negron wins the faceoff, taken away by Akron. Centering attempt there by Steffel, but nobody was home. Gavin tries to take it away. Losing a stick there was Kantner. Recollects it and is able to backhand it back into Akron's zone. Rink beats Steffel to the puck and gets it back up ahead. Boehm has some room now. Boehm takes it the other way into Kent State's zone. Boehm tries to center it, but he loses possession of it momentarily, and that allows Blomqvist to clear it, but it's held in there by Wilson. Puck's below the net now as a shot bounced just wide of the net, taken away by Gavin, and Boehm has a flash down as a long-range shot there is stopped and held by Coyne. Shot was by Manorino. Face-off won by the Flashes, taking it behind their net. Spirited battle in front of the net there between Bruno and Supek. Flashes come out for the better on it, though, and get it deep into Akron zone once more. Chasing after the puck there successfully is Sanchez. Sanchez has it behind the net. Sharp angle shot, he scores! And Kent State's on the board. What a beautiful move by senior Alex Sanchez. And he signals to his team, that's one. Sanchez got around on his own, faked the wraparound, got Hughes to bite for it. Hughes resets, and he tucks one just over his left shoulder, far side. Impressive sharp angle shot there by Sanchez to cut the Zips lead in half. Flashes take the face off and Meyer dumps it back in. Volker chases after it. Zips take it away, but Meyer hits Bruno there and forces the Zips to reset. Renjiak puts it up ahead for Gasha. Back for Renjiak. Trying to fire a shot. Sticked away by Coyne. Hit hard below the net. There was Lustig, but he was able to advance the puck still. It's taken away by Gasha for a shot. That's blocked by Supek. Supek clears it out off the boards back into the neutral zone before Bujiak puts it back in. Lustig below his own net. Harassed by Gasha. Big hit there! And that's going to be a penalty. 24th collide as Manorino hit Lustig very hard, and Lustig's down, and he's not getting up. Lustig is down with his helmet off, holding his head as the trainer comes out. Minute 3 to go here in the first period. Things not looking great here for Lustig. Lustig clearly alert and communicating with the trainer as he's able to sit up. Takes a breather. Discussion with the trainer ongoing. Well, naturally, the first thing you're worried about when you got a player holding his head off of a big open ice hit like that is a concussion. As Lustig is helped up by his teammates. But skating under his own power. Lustig sits down, but he stays on the bench. Looking to take a breather as team captains Sippel and Meyer will go to discuss with the referees. Currently sitting in the box is Manorino, but we'll have to see what the official call on that is. So far, he's the only one in the box. Both teams return to their bench. And it looks like Manorino will be leaving this game. Manorino sends his regards to the crowd. And the Golden Flashes give him a parting gift. This will be a 5-minute major. As Cal Rink goes to the box to serve that 5-minute penalty. 5-minute major and an ejection. Refs telling the Flashes to get this game started back up again. Presumably a 5-minute ejection for head contact, but no official word on that yet. So Kent State will go on an extended 5-minute power play for the final minute 3 of this period, and then a further 3:57 to start the second. And remember, on a major penalty like this, it doesn't matter how many goals you score, it doesn't come off the board. Face-off won by the Flashes. Gets back for Sanchez. Sanchez puts it down deep for Volker. Volker on the right side. Back for Sanchez. Sanchez across. For Meyer. Meyer back to Sanchez. Sanchez for Meyer. Meyer gets out into the center. Meyer fires a low shot. That's stopped and held by Hughes. 40 seconds to go here. Flashes win the faceoff. Volker on the right wing, back for Sanchez. Sanchez fumbles it and has to retreat back out into the neutral zone. Sanchez turning and goes back in with speed. Stops up high at the top circles, trying to dump it off there, but a little too much speed there on the part of Kantner. Gets back out for Sanchez. Meyer puts it back for Sanchez. Sanchez moves in, fires, he scores! No, he doesn't. Fooled me and the crowd. Had a perfect shot blocker, but it looks like Hughes was just able to stop that. As it gets back from Meyer, and the Flashes will hold it, and that'll do it for the first period. Sanchez almost getting his second of the night there again. Looks from my angle and from most of the crowd's angle like it was going in, but somehow stays out there. team set here for the start of the second period. As Kent State, down 2-1, still has just under 4 minutes remaining on a major penalty. That saw Akron U defenseman Manorino, ejected for a hit to the head on his opposite number, Ryan Lustig. Face-off won by the Flashes. Sanchez takes it in. Quick drag there, but it's stolen away by Akron and trying to shovel it out into the neutral zone. And makes it all the way to the ceiling, and it'll stay in the Akron U zone for the face-off. Meyer wins the face-off. Puck gets back to Sipple. Sipple drops it back for Meyer. Sanchez ends up with it off the defensive stick play by Akron. Sipple at the line. Back down for Sanchez. Sanchez moves and tries to center it for Volker. He can't get it. Meyer has it back now. Cross for Sanchez. Sanchez trying to center it there this time for Kantner, but blocked up an escape. As it ends up out in front of the net, and Hughes will hold on. Still 3:17 to go here on the extended power play for KSU. As aforementioned, Kent State not a glorious power play so far. 13.6% on the season as the puck gets out. Long range attempt there by Sipple. Goes off a body and doesn't make it all the way to the net as Akron U clears it. Taken away by Sanchez. Up for Meyer. Meyer wants to carry, and Sanchez is just a hair offside. Well, Kent State for the second home game in a row likes to go with CJ Coyne in net. Coyne at a 4.06 GAA and an .878 save percentage. He's got 2 wins on the season. This decision makes sense, though, as Hammonds played the previous night against Akron U. At Akron. Meanwhile, long-range, sharp-angle shot there by Negron. As Akron takes it the other way, they've got a 2-on-1. Gets up ahead for Buzziak, and it's stopped by Coyne. Good shoulder stop there by Coyne. As Blomqvist starts to take it back the other way. Blomqvist across the red line and then the blue. Stops up at the blue line. Drops it off for Ambach. Ambach trying to wrap it around the net, and Corlew is forced to clean that up and get it back around. Kantner. Long range shot attempt there by Blomqvist. That's blocked up by the Zips. Trying to break free is Wilson. He almost does, but loses possession of the puck. Shadowing him there is Negron. Negron knocks him down, and the Flashes retake possession. Negron with speed. Negron fires a shot. That's stopped. The rebound pops back out to him. Tries to center it for Volker. It bounces off a skate. Sipple's forced to settle it down at the blue line. Tries to put it back in, but Wilson stops that and will clear it all the way back down. Bruno's ahead. Wins the race. Bruno gets it back for Gasha. Grasha, sorry, who tries to fire a shot, but that's partially blocked and goes out of play. Well, with just a minute 22 to go here on Kent State's power play, they got to hope for at least one here, but nothing so far. Defensive zone faceoff on the power play, taken by Sanchez. Sanchez forced to retreat and reset. Looks over his options, gets it up to Sipple. Sipple up for Volker. Volker brings it into the offensive zone. Briefly taken away, but some aggression there by Sanchez gets it back in deep. Backhanded back in deep by Meyer. Trying to clear it there was Buzziak, but he can't. Bounces off the net, and Volker takes it away. Almost gets in on a close-range opportunity. Skate of Meyer there, keeping it in, gets it off for Volker. That was Kantner looking for a shot that got blocked. Held in there by Meyer. Kent State trying to get the pressure on. But Akron will take it away and clear it once again. Just over 30 seconds to go here on the power play. Sipple takes it in front of his net, looks over his options. He's shadowed by Ocon. Didn't get everything he wanted on it, but he got it up ahead to Korlu anyways, and Korlu advances it deeper into the zone, but the Zips retake possession there and once again clear it. One last rush here on the power play as time ticks down on it. Meyer gets in deep on the right side but loses possession of the puck, and the Zips will clear it again and finish off this penalty as Rink gets out of the box. A full 5 minute major power play killed off by Akron. Kent State looked to tie the game back up, but not successful in that. Meanwhile, Negron takes it back up the zone on the left side, avoids a hit there. As Steffel chases after it, can't quite get there. So Stellabot was forced to retreat, gets it off for Van Sykel, who drives it deep once again. Dreese takes it away. Dreese's in. Dreese gets knocked down. Akron playing a very physical game so far tonight. As that's taken away, Ocon gets it up. Ocon tries to backhand it on that, easily sticked aside there. And a delayed penalty coming to the Zips. Dreese gets it out in the neutral zone, and it looks like we'll see Gavin go to the box for a cross check. Third power play of the night. For Kent State. Akron, you so far killed off a minor penalty and a major penalty. And Kent State brings the first unit back out. Faceoff won and immediately cleared by the Zips. That forces Sipple to chase all the way down into his defensive zone. Chips it up for Kantner, who leaves it off for Meyer. Meyer has Volker trying to get some speed, but he loses it. And Sanchez picks that up and passes over to Sipple. Sipple down to Kantner, back to Sipple. Back again to Kantner. Kantner retreats back, and the miscommunication there by Sipple. Tries to get it to Kantner, not successful, so Akron U will clear it again. Coyne being aggressively chased there by Grasha, so he's forced to play that puck. And there's a Viper at the line, but Meyer has some room now, one-on-one. Meyer tries to gain some room there, sticked up by Boehm, and he can't get a shot off. He still holds the puck, though, gets back to the blue line. Comes back in, fires a shot, he scores! Beautiful top corner shot there by Meyer! And Kent State has a power play goal to tie it back up! Well, even with Kent State not having the best power play, taking enough penalties will do that to you. And that just kind of comes with the territory when you're playing as aggressive and physical a game as Akron is, running a bit high on emotions there. An ill-advised cross-checking penalty gives Meyer all the room he needs to fire that one up high. Over the shoulder, Kent State's got the lead. And now a penalty coming to the Flashes. As Akron lays the pressure on, and Coyne will stop that one and hold on to it. Tripping call coming to Kent State. And that penalty will be there on Stellabot. It'll be for tripping. Well, statistically, while not the best power play, Kent State has a phenomenal penalty kill, 87.8%. And their leading power play goal scorer has 3 goals, but penalty killer Sanchez has 4 shorthanded goals. Long range shot there by Grasha, stopped in traffic, and cleared all the way out by Steffel. Hughes out to play that. Hughes puts it up ahead for Renziak. Renziak leaves that off for Wilson, and Wilson gains the zone with speed. Wilson takes a hit there from Ambach, but gets it off to Grasha anyways. Grasha to Renziak. Renziak, a long-range shot. That's blocked by Steffel.
gets a penalty for number 8, Gio Stillebaugh.
Bernard keeps the play alive. As Boehm was, sorry, Thomas was looking for Grasha, but a good active stick there by Van Sickle prevents that. Grasha has it now. Good block there by Steffel. Steffel's got two blocks on this penalty kill and forces the Zips to retreat. Renjiak takes it back in. Chips it in and will chase after it. Ambach gets there first, leaves it for Van Sickle, who's able to clear it all the way down. Under a minute to go in this power play. Good defending so far by Kent State. Good positioning, good blocks, clogging up lanes. You can really see why Kent State's got such a successful penalty kill. Wilson takes it back the other way and crosses the line. Looks for some room, doesn't have it, so we'll circle around. Falling over there was Bujiak, so he's forced to chip it back down for Grasha. Grasha fakes the leave-off, firing a shot, that's stopped by Coyne. Sipple gets there first, Wilson stops it at the line. Gloved back down by Sipple and cleared all the way out. Boehm, one last rush attempt chance for Akron. Leaves it off for Ocon. Ocon crosses the line. Ocon has some space, fires a shot, that goes wide. Boehm holds it. Flashes kill off the penalty, gets it up ahead to Meyer. Meyer starts heading the other way, one-on-one. Meyer gets around to Meyer, it's alone! Backhand, what a poke check by Hughes! Meyer was in alone and he had Hughes beat. And at the last second, a desperation attempt by Hughes. A diving poke check knocks it off of Meyer's stick and keeps this game tied. Akron then ices the puck. Two phenomenal moves there by two completely different players. Meyer with a beautiful move to get in all alone and get around that defenseman. And a great desperation poke check by Hughes to keep this a tie game. Zips win the faceoff. Bujiak harassed there in the corner, falling over. Both Bujiak and Supek trying to hold it in. Not successfully was Ambach. Zips have numbers, but Bruno is hit hard and a delayed penalty coming to Supek. Ref took a moment to raise that hand. Supek takes exception to that and is wondering what was illegal about the hit. And he's getting a cross-checking penalty. Well, kills one penalty successfully and then immediately takes another one, really. Looks like Kent State's quality penalty kill at almost 90% is going to be challenged. Sippel, Sanchez, Kantner, and Blomqvist out there as the Flash is killers. Off the faceoff is Yeast. Yeast harassed there by Blomqvist. Drops it off for Sanchez, who takes it the other way. Sanchez leads it up on ahead for Kantner. Kantner chases in this, hit hard there off the boards by Renjiak. It's slow to get up, but he's still skating. Renjiak takes it the other way now. Gains some space, but falls over. And not sure what the referee's calling here. The net went all the way off for about a minute 31 to go here on the Zips power play as the play goes out of the zone. Seems like they're taking it outside of the zone because Renjiak knocked the net off its moorings. Renjiak gets the puck off the faceoff, tries to center it, taken away by the Flashes, and Meyer clears it all the way down. Steffel chasing it quickly. Steffel will win that race. Tries to backhand it off the skate of Hughes, not successful, and the Zips will retake that. Wilson up on ahead for Bujiak. Taken back by Wilson. Wilson's got some room. Wilson gets around. Sticked away by Meyer. Wilson forced to retreat there, back to the blue line. Leaving it off there for Bernard. Bernard over to Renjiak, fires a shot. Briefly losing sight of that was Coyne, but it ends up in the pants of Meyer briefly before Bujiak retakes it. Bujak across for Wilson. Wilson fires a shot that goes wide. Bujak manages to hold that. Sorry, that's Yeast firing a shot that goes wide. Wilson will collect it at the top circles. 30 seconds to go on the power play. Wilson fires a shot that misses. Grasha with it now at the top circle. Grasha holds. Off for Wilson. Wilson looks over his options, gets to Grasha. Grasha centering it. Puck's loose. Firing a shot. Saved by Coyne. Dogpile in front of the net there. It doesn't go. Grasha holds it now. Back up top. Grasha gets around the defender. Grasha fires. Redirected. And it doesn't get all the way to the goalie. And down there is Yeast. Penalty kill by Kent State. And firing a shot there at the very end of the power play was Wilson, but it goes out of play. That's two consecutive penalties killed off by the Flashes. And they will remain perfect on the penalty kill tonight. I hope to get this offense back on track. Van Sickle will take the faceoff against Bruno. Zips win it. Trying to center it out in front there. And Amory can't get a stick on it. So the Flashes take the other way. Volker with it. Volker crosses the line. Volker with a backhand shot. That's stopped by Hughes. Gets it out for Sanchez. Sanchez at the goal line. Back below the net for Volker. Volker curls around. Volker shoots. Stopped by Hughes. Pinching there was Bloomquist, but it's taken away by Akron anyways. Bruno with it the other way. Amory waits at the line. Bruno takes it in. Gets out for Ocon. Ocon fires a shot that's stopped and held on by Coyne. 8:25 to go here in the second period. Still tied up at two after Kent State finally capitalizes on their third power play of the game. Special teams proving important so far. Three power plays for Kent State, including a five-minute power play, and two power plays for Akron, not able to capitalize on any of them so far. Gavin down in the zone, puck behind both players, and that's taken up the other way by Supek. Akron holds it in at the line, though, as it bounces off a player. Gavin trying to center it there, blocked by Bloomqvist, and the puck is out loose in front of the net, and taking it the other way is Corlew, but he gets sticked up and loses possession. Coyne settles that. And Sipple leaves it up for Corlew, but Corlew can't get there. So Zips will take it back in the other way. It's Rink now. Rink crosses the line on the right side. Stops up and reverses. Centers it out in front, taken away by the Flashes. Corlew takes it and backhands it across. No icing on the play. Dreese will chase after it. As Owen and Telasco come in off the bench looking for their chances. Taken now by Schaefer. Schaefer behind the net. Schaefer advances the puck. Leads it up on ahead looking for Soderstrom, but he's not there. So the Zips will put it back in deep. Van Sickle now. Van Sickle up ahead for Soderstrom. Soderstrom gloves it out of the air and into the zone, but Amory takes it. No hand pass. Up ahead for Ocon. Ocon crosses the line as it gets all the way back there to Yeast, who tries to shovel it into the zone, but it again hits the ceiling and thus out of play. Good effort there by Kent State so far to fight back and get back into this game, tie it back up. Some back and forth action here in the second as the puck gets to Ocon at the blue line and he throws it in. Winning the race for that there, Stellabot, as Akron takes it back at the line and throws it in deep again. Hit there off the puck was Lyle. Good hit there by Ambach. And tripped up there is Volker, and we will get another power play coming to the Flashes, but Meyer comes the other way into the corner. Meyer loses a tire, and that's taken by the Zips, and We will get our fourth power play of the night for the Golden Flashes. Tripping call coming to Ocon. We will get a look.
Yeah, you tell him, Max!
At KSU. Fourth power play of the night. Usual suspects here in the blue line for Kent State, Sanchez and Sipple. Puck gets back to Sanchez off the faceoff. Sanchez puts that back in deep for Kantner. Kantner fakes the pass, holds onto it at the blue line, chips it in there for Meyer. Meyer puts it in deep. Corlew. Corlew at the goal line, reverses, goes behind the net. Corlew out for Sanchez. Sanchez fires a shot that's just barely stopped by Hughes. Corlew recollects it in the right corner. Corlew tries to get it up to Sanchez. He can't collect it. Sipple tries to stick it out of the air to keep it in, not successfully. Sipple advances it back for Kantner. Kantner up to Volker. Volker crosses the line. Weaves his way across. Gets in. Volker hit hard there, but he gets it across. He scores! Sacrificing the body! Passes it off for Negron, who fires it against the grain! And the Flashes have their first lead of the night! Two power play goals in a row! Golden Flashes now sit 2-for-4 on the power play on the night, and this is more of what we were talking about, where if you keep taking penalties like Akron has, you're running that risk, even against the worst power plays. They do score. And KSU is now 50% on the night. Volker created some space there before taking a hard hit by Renziak. But he left it perfectly off for Negron. Negron drove the net, fired it against the grain, far side, blocker side, and picked a corner to give them their third goal of the night and their first lead of the night. Off the faceoff, puck bounces up and comes out of play. Supek will take the faceoff now against the recently freed from the box, Ocon. Faceoff won by the Zips, but Ambach takes that and throws it back into Akron's zone. Zips recollected on the stick of Lyle. Lyle drops it off there for Bernard, and Bernard starts to take it the other way. Bouncing off the skate of Supek as Ocon is hit hard there by Corlew. Zips take it there. Boehm trying to advance it. It bounces off a stick and goes all the way into Kent's zone. Ambach fighting Amory for the puck. Squeezes out below the net. Now Lyle fighting with it, taken away by Stellabot. Stellabot has his attempt stymied, and it gets to Amory. Amory, a long-range shot blocked off the stick of Supek. Stays in play. Centering pass attempt there by Ocon, but no one was home, so it gets all the way out to the defense of Akron. Boehm just barely holds it in. Boehm gets it back down for Amory. Sorry, Ocon. Held in there by Bernard. Bernard holds onto it, drops it back down for Ocon. Ocon drives the net, fires a shot, stopped by Coyne. As Ambach takes it the other way. Ambach leads Dreese. Dreese can't collect it, but gets a piece on it. Chased by Schaefer. Schaefer manages to stop that attempt up. Gets it for Sanchez. Sanchez drags! Stopped by Hughes! The rebound wasn't there. Great stop by Hughes. Great play by Sanchez. As a redirect attempt there off the shot on Van Cycle was just wide. Schaefer holds it at the goal line now. Sanchez below the net. Sanchez wheels around. Puts it on net. Goes just wide. Taken away by Boehm. And pitchforked out to the neutral zone. Zelasko to chase. Zelasko off for Van Cycle. Flash is reset. Van Cycle weaving his way into the neutral zone. Loses it but drops it off for Kantner. Sorry, Negron. Flash to take it the other way. Here's Sanchez looking for some room. Sanchez trying to center it for Negron but wasn't there. So Wilson takes it the other way. Fires a long-range shot. Blocker save by Coyne. Negron has some room now. Negron fires a long-range shot against the grain just high. Chases after the play and gets a hit off there on Yeast. And now fighting for possession of the puck with Yeast. Wins it and chips it out to center, but taken back by the Zips as Sipple chases. And Steffel chases as well. Steffel wins that race. Briefly touches it behind the net before Yeast and the Zips get it back. Yeast tries back into neutral zone, taken away by Sanchez, but just barely offside. So Kent will take this opportunity to go for a line change. Retreating there, seeing a play coming, was Stellabata, but taken back away by Drisi in the offensive zone. Drisi leaves it off for Supek, who dumps it back in. Good hit there by Corlew to knock the puck off the Akron stick. Stellabata, a long-range shot. That's blocked by Wilson. Backhanded back into the zone now. Taken away by the Zips. Big hit there on Renciak. And it'll be a penalty. Flash is arguing their case, but falling on deaf ears as Supek joins, goes back into the penalty box for the second time tonight. Partial power play on the period for Akron U as they will, barring a goal, spend the last 125 of the second period on the power play with a further 35 seconds to start this third period. Coaches and fans alike vocalizing their disagreement with the linesman on that call. Regardless, Kent State's got their third penalty kill of the night. They win the faceoff and it gets all the way down. Good speed there by Sanchez trying to take it away, but Akron gets reinforcements and Ocon starts to take it up the other way. Harassing him though is Meyer. Aggressive penalty kill here by Kent State. As Wilson crosses the line. Wilson gaining some room. Wilson with speed. Goes around the net looking for the wraparound. Good block there by Sipple to prevent that wraparound attempt. He was wide open there if he had gotten all the way around. Ocon holds it at the top circles. Down low. Looking out in front for Grescia, but good blocking lane there by Meyer prevents the pass from getting across. Ocon puts it at the net. And Coyne dives down and grabs that. 32 seconds to go here in the second period. 1:07 on the Akron power play. Drisi wins the faceoff. Final 30 seconds of play. Ambach chases after it. Taken by Grescia. Grescia out for Ocon. Ocon up for Bernard. Bernard holds the puck. Bernard moves in. Shoots. Blocked there by Steffel. Chasing after it there was Wilson, but he falls down, and Ambach's able to get it all the way out. Ocon resets. Less than 10 to go here. And with 4.4 to go, Akron is offside. Great second period so far here. Only 4.4 seconds to go. I can't imagine there'll be much more, but Ambach joining Supek in the box. And for a short period of time, for the remainder of this period, and to start the third, Kent State's got their work cut out for them on a 5-on-3 penalty kill. Shot there! Off the post! Rebound scores! Refs calling it a good goal. Kent State arguing that time expired. Immediately capitalizing on that power play is Akron as Wilson gets his second goal of the night. Coaches on Kent State's bench screaming at the referee, arguing that the play clock had expired on the second period. Shows zeros on the clock, and Akron is... Both teams are leaving the bench. Referees are discussing. The initial shot went off the post. The rebound was collected there by Wilson and got past Coyne. Referees discussing the play. Both captains still on the ice, Sipple and Ocon. Play is being reviewed at the moment. the ensuing 4.4 second 5-on-3. So we will enter the third period tied, and Kent State will have a minute and 56 seconds to kill off of the Ambach penalty. So far, Kent State looking to go 3-for-4 on the penalty kill. And once again, penalties rearing their head to show how important they are. Both teams getting set for the opening faceoff of the final period. Meyer versus Wilson. Kent State wins it and clears it all the way down just into Akron's zone as it's chased after there by Sanchez. Taken away by Bernard up for Wilson. Wilson crosses the line. Wilson below the net. Drops it off for Renjiak. Renjiak across for Bernard. Bernard back for Renjiak. Slap shot stopped and held on to by Coyne. Puck was loose, but refs lost sight. Kent State fans showing their appreciation for a fan who's been ejected for some type of misconduct. Bernard holds it at the blue line. Bernard moves in, fires a shot that's wide. Looks like it was just tipped by a flash. Held in by Grescia, but it gets up to Kantner, who shovels it all the way down, and he's going to force the streaking Steffel is going to force Hughes to cover the puck. So with a minute and 4 seconds to go on this penalty kill, the Flashes are going to have an offensive zone faceoff. And you have to imagine Sanchez with his 4 shorthanded goals licking their chops at this opportunity. Faceoff gets out into the neutral zone. Van Cycle will chip that back into Akron's zone briefly. Ocon holds it now in his own zone. Lead pass there for Boehm. Boehm breaks it in on the left side. Sharp angle shot by Boehm, stopped by Coyne. Stellabot now tries to clear it, held in by Buzziak, but it's a high stick. Seconds left here on the Ambach penalty. And Kent State gets another offensive zone faceoff. This time they'll win it cleanly. Stellabato will drive it into the boards and pin it up against it to kill some time as the Flashes take a moment to collect it and take it the other way. Taken back by Meyer. Meyer tries to clear it unsuccessfully. Amory has it now. Amory chips it back up for Ocon at the blue line. Ocon holds it. Gets it down to Lyle. Lyle tries to advance it, but that's blocked by the Flashes and cleared all the way back down. And that should do it for this power play. Kent State now 3-for-4 on the penalty kill. Ambach returns to the bench as Kent State will look to get back to where they were headed in the second period before the end of period goal. Taken away by Ocon now. Backhanded. Blocked there in traffic. And a 2-on-1 developing here for Kent State. Negron tried to find Kantner, not successful. Laying the body to try to keep it there was Bloomquist, unsuccessfully. Amory takes it the other way. And this time Negron hammers Amory into the boards. But holding it at the line is Thomas. Thomas chips it back in for Akron. Sipple with it now. Sipple leads Kantner for it. Gloved in by Renjiak, but Kent State takes it back. Negron was looking for Supek, but he couldn't get there. So it's icing Kent State with 17:06 to go in regulation. Cal Rink against Gavin Supek at the faceoff. And Supek comes out on top there. Gets it back for Sipple. Flashes bring it out into the neutral zone. Supek drops it all the way into the offensive zone for Kent State. Big hit there on Yeast by Corlew, as the Zips try to lead Gavin up ahead for a breakaway, but they couldn't get there. Wilson unable to prevent an icing for Akron as the Flashes get another offensive zone opportunity. Meyer will take the faceoff, get it back briefly for Volker before being picked off by Wilson. Wilson has some room here. It's going to be too wide for him to get a breakaway, though, and he's forced to get it behind the net, but Van Sickel forces him to lose the puck. Held at the line by Boehm. Van Sickel takes the puck there, taken back by Wilson. But the puck gets out to the Flashes, and Sanchez takes it the other way. Two on two here. Sanchez with it, looks to get some room. He does. Wraparound attempt. That was stopped by Hughes. The rebound there. Meyer couldn't collect. Held in by Stellenbata. Briefly taken away by Akron as the Flashes will take it right back. Sanchez wasn't able to collect that, so it goes out in the neutral zone. Ambach leaving it off for Stellenbata. Stellenbata in. Fires a long-range shot. Blocked in the skates of Boehm. Yace chased after that. Steffel tries to get a shot on net. It goes wide. Ambach with a shot there, also wide. Steffel collects in the right corner. Tries to backhand it up for Ambach. Ambach has to retreat to get it. Ambach will throw it all the way back in, almost. Catches Hughes off guard, but he drops just in time to lay it off on the side. Kept in by the hand of Sipple. Drops it off for Kantner. Kantner shoots just wide. Chased by Negron. Bernard will collect it and throw it there. Chasing after it there, Grescia. And it's just narrowly an icing. Five minutes gone here in the third period. Some back and forth action. A couple of good opportunities both ways. Akron getting a few opportunities on that partial power play. Kent State getting a few opportunities in return. But both Hughes and Coyne have held strong to this point. Another offensive zone opportunity for Kent State. Faceoff won by them. Bloomquist fires a long-range shot. That's stopped in the skates. Bruno. Bruno backhands it out into the neutral zone, but Kent State throws it right back in. Now it's Boehm with it. Boehm for Thomas. Thomas trying to lead a pass for Amory, but taken away by Van Sickel, who brings it in offside. Supek will take the faceoff against Ocon. Tries to get around him, not successful. And Akron will ice the puck again. A lot of these faceoffs here starting in Akron zone. And similar to the penalties they're taking, you have to imagine that eventually it's going to put them in danger. They were dangerous. Alex Sanchez there on left wing. Face off one by Meyer, gets it to Volker. Volker tries to put it on net, can't get everything on it. Van Sickel holds it in. Shovels that back in deep. Taken away by the Zips. Ocon tries to break it out. He does. Ocon has some room there. Amory tries to clean up the remains, isn't successful. So Akron's got to regroup. Lyle takes it back in and then puts it the other way. Collected there in his own zone by Zelasco. Zelasco leads it up for Sanchez. Sanchez forced by the physicality of the Zips to just get a piece on it. Sanchez chases after that, though, and it's just barely held in by Sipple. Taken away by the Zips. Taken back by Meyer. Meyer's got room. Backhand just wide. The rebound opportunity is there. Hughes has it. Well, the backhander by Meyer bounces off the glass behind the net and gets out in front for Sanchez, who tries to stuff it home, but Hughes holds strong. More good offensive opportunities for Kent developing here. Partway through this third period, almost at the halfway mark. Ethan Steffel will take the faceoff. Steffel will face off against Rink. Steffel will win it. Trying to center it there was Kantner, and he couldn't. But it bounced off some players and forced Hughes to cover it again. Hughes trying to keep his team in the game here as Kent State has Akron on their heels. Offensive zone faceoff after offensive zone faceoff. One again by Steffel. Steffel gets a shot off of it, but it goes off the stick of Renshiak out of play. So now Negron will take the face off with Steffel on the left wing. Negron wins it, gets it down for Kantner. Kantner fighting Yeast for it. Some physicality there as Renjiak is hit up by Negron as Wilson gets it into Kent State's zone. Taken away now by Bloomquist. Bloomquist behind his own net. Starts to take it up before advancing it to Negron. Negron looks ahead for Kantner, can't get there. And that'll be an icing. Referee's still enforcing the line change. Rule of icing. The ACHA. Face off won by Kent State as Dreese is tripped up, and Akron will go on their fifth penalty kill. That is Thomas going to the box for tripping. Good draw there by Dreese, using his speed to get it up ahead a little bit and give the Flashes another power play. They've capitalized on two straight. Let's see if they can go for three. Flashes collected off the faceoff. Zips will take it and clear it all the way down. Coin forced to make a stop. Grescia gets there first, takes it for Akron. Tries to get in front of the net, but it's held off by Sipple. Holds on to it. Curls around. Now being harassed by two Flashes. Now being harassed by three Flashes before he dumps it all the way back into his own zone for Bernard to collect, who throws the puck all the way back down into Kent's zone. Kent State really looking to get going here, and they just can't do it as it's taken away by the Zips once again. Zips just having a bit of a free-for-all here, passing it to each other. Kent State's giving them way too much room as Ocon will fire it all the way into Kent's zone once more before the Flashes will finally recollect it on the stick of Negron. Starts to take it the other way. Has a bit of speed as he crosses the line. Stops up at the top circles. Looks for a shot, tries to take it, and that's blocked by Boehm. Held in by Bloomquist. Bloomquist dumps it deep. Volker will collect it. Volker back for Bloomquist. Gets it off for Ambach. Ambach a shot, trying to get the backhand on that. Was Negron, but he couldn't get a stick there. Flashes retreat back into the neutral zone. Bloomquist backhands it up for Steffel. Steffel looks for Corlew. But Ambach gets it instead. Ambach tries to take a shot. Another block by Boehm. Trying to get the rebound there was Corlew, but it goes just wide. Ambach across for Sanchez. Sanchez tries to send it out in front. A third block by Boehm. Ocon takes it now. Curls backwards and throws it at his own bench. Taken by Wilson. Wilson drags it into his own zone. Penalty about to expire. Back for Ocon. And a successful kill there by Akron. Pretty clinical kill there by Akron. A couple of good opportunities there at the very end of it by Kent State. But other than that, Akron held way too much possession as it's taken away in Kent's zone by Thomas. Thomas has it. Fires a shot. That's stopped by Coyne. Kantner fights for it and Corlew gets it, but it's held in by Renziak. Van Cycle now throws it all the way down, and that'll be an icing on Kent State. No, it will not, as Hughes goes out to collect it. So the Zips start to take it the other way, and they ice it. Looking for the lead pass as Kent State made a dangerous line change was Lyle. He's all alone in the neutral zone, but couldn't take the stretch pass, so it's an icing on the Zips. Golden Flashes get a bit of a break there as they ice the puck, but Hughes comes out to play it, negates the icing, and tries to leave Lyle for a pass, misses, and ices it himself. Flashes win the faceoff. Trying to put that on net was Stellavatta, but it goes off a skate. Taken away by Renziak, taken back by Supak. Shot attempt there by Ambach, blocked by Gavin, taken by Dreese. Dreese moving in, firing a shot. That's stopped and held by Hughes. It's like Hughes very briefly didn't know where that went, but he knew he had it. So he drops down and covers that. Flash is really laying the pressure on now. You can see that they're a lot more comfortable at 5-on-5 than on the man advantage. As Meyer takes the faceoff, Akron wins it. Yace rings it around the boards. Ambach tries to take it, and he'll elect to turn and throw it back in. Yace gets it back, fumbles on it, and briefly taken away by Volker before it's knocked off of his stick. Volker tries to tip it on, but it goes wide. Yace up for Boehm. Sanchez looks for the hit on Boehm, but aborted at the last second. As it gets deep into Kent's zone. Taken by Ambach. Ambach finds Sanchez, who leads it up for Meyer. Meyer looks to take it into the zone. He's hit, but he gets back on the puck, firing a shot just wide. Van Cycle turns on the Jets to try to keep it in, but it's taken away. Grescia has a 2-on-1 with Thomas. Grescia gets it out to Thomas, but Thomas has it knocked off his stick by Sanchez. Great work by Sanchez there to get all the way back, as Akron is forced to dump it back in. Van Cycle wins the race. Gets it up ahead. Kantner has it now. Curls backwards. Kantner tries to find Negron, but Negron isn't there. So it goes deep into Akron's zone for an icing. Bit of debate there by Kent State as they believe Richards could have gotten that, but icing is icing. Here to take the face-off now is Steffel. Face-off against Ocon. Physicality driving them both to their feet as Akron U wins it. And Negron tries to turn on the Jets as Bujiak couldn't keep it in. Oh! Negron gets knocked down with some head contact. No call on the play as a long-range shot by Sipple. Just off the top part of the glove of Hughes. Holding it in at the line is Bloomquist. Sipple pinches in to keep that in play. Taken away by Steffel. Steffel comes around the left side, puts it on net, and that goes off the skates of Bujiak. Trying to send it out in front for Steffel, but he couldn't get there. As Akron will clear it all the way down for an icing. Akron once again trying to sneak a line change. You can see that Buzziak is really tired, but the refs catch it and force him back out there. Supek will take the face off. Won by the Zips. But good effort there by Corlew to chase it down. Supek has it now below the net. Hit up hard there before getting some room. Fires a shot, save, rebound, another save! It gets out to the defense. Firing a shot is Stellenbott. And it gets blocked and out of play. Very good opportunity there by Kent State. And Akron U just hangs on and gets a much, much needed line change. 7:08 to go here in regulation. Supek wins the faceoff, tries to get a shot off, but can't. Corlew fighting for that puck, boards up Gavin. Taken away by the Zips. Heading the other way now is Rink. Rink backhands it up for Wilson. Wilson can't get there in time, so Ambach advances it back into the neutral zone. Supek's got some room. Supek takes it up. He's alone. Supek hit hard there by Renjiak, who loses his footing. As Gavin is hit hard there by Ambach. Sorry, that was Stellenbott. Wilson takes it the other way looking for a breakaway, but Ambach chases it down first. Wilson unsuccessfully tries to take it away. Wilson being really aggressive, but clearly low on energy. Flashes start to take it the other way. Sanchez looking for Volker, but Volker can't quite get a piece of that, so it gets out to the Akron U defense. Boehm retreats deep into his own zone. Gives it off for Yeast. Yeast backhands it back for Boehm. Boehm behind his own net. As Wilson dumps down Meyer behind the play. No call. The Flashes take it back and start to head the other way. A little bit of a frustration play there by Meyer. Clearly upset that there was no call and he was interfered with in the neutral zone. But nonetheless, the Flashes take it the other way. Kantner looks for somewhere. He's got it! Kantner fires a shot, stopped by Hughes! Opportunities aplenty for the Flashes. Meyer takes it, shoots, saved, and covered by Hughes. Some third period heroics here by Hughes to keep this game tied. Referees barking at Kent State for trying to make a line change too early. They'll get their desired players out now. Steffel will take the faceoff. And Akron U will manage to get possession on that. Chased down by Negron. Can't get there. Kantner with it now. Drops it off for Steffel. Steffel has it back. Steffel's hit along the boards, but he keeps going. Centering pass! Save by Hughes! One-timer there by Negron. Good save by Hughes. Ambach shadowed there by Grescia, but Ambach manages to get there first and takes it the other way. Ambach's in with speed. Ambach puts on net. Stopped! Rebound isn't there! Ambach tries to turn and backhand it on net. That's stopped by Ocon. Ocon starts to take it the other way. Ocon looks for some room up the center ice. Ambach hit hard there by Ocon. Kent State manages to get it out into the neutral zone. Ambach holds it there in his own zone. Leaves it up on head for Corlew. Corlew tried to spring Supek there, but Supek couldn't handle it. Backhanded into the zone there by Lyle. As Kent State takes it back. Lead pass there for Supek. Supek can't collect it, but he does get a piece on it, getting it deep into Akron's zone. Hit from a tough angle there by Bernard. No call on the play, but he manages to get it on net, surrounded by three Zips. And that's held by Hughes. Now below 5 minutes to play in regulation. Kent State. And now the referee yelling at the Akron coach. Same referee that was just giving some guff to the Kent State bench, but not entirely sure what about. But Boehm was trying to come off before being forced back on. Faceoff won by the Flashes. Bloomquist has it, drops it off for Meyer. Meyer backhands it deep. Sanchez gets dumped down there by Boehm. And Boehm loses his helmet. Not sure what the refs are planning to call here, but they blew the whistle off of Boehm holding on to Sanchez. I don't know if they're taking one, taking both, or taking neither. As Sanchez heads to the box, Sipple is incensed as Kent State will go on their fifth penalty kill of the game. Kent State fans letting the refs know what they think of that as Coach Miles Radicevic calls the referees over wanting an explanation. Referees getting a little upset themselves. Been called over for a lot of questionable things that either side takes exception to. But Zips win the faceoff to start their power play. Boehm drops it off for Ocon. Ocon looks over his options. Fires a shot. That gets in traffic. McCoy makes a stop. Rebound by Boehm. Doesn't get to the net this time. Boehm has it now. Drops it all the way back for Bernard. Bernard across to Ocon. Ocon fakes the shot. Backhands it now. That goes just wide. Bloomquist gets there first. Tries to clear it off the backhand. Held in by Bernard. Chased down there by Kantner and forces them to get it back. One-timer attempt by Boehm. Blocker saved by Coyne. Coyne followed that one-timer all the way there and was able to get a high blocker on it. Grescia takes it now. Tries to get towards the net. Curls around below the net and puts it right into the pads of Coyne, who covers it. Referees micromanaging the line changes here. Not entirely sure I've seen anything like this before. But we will let the officials officiate. Zips win the faceoff once again. It's all the way down this time to Bujiak. Bujiak down to Yeast. Yeast below the net to Wilson. Wilson looking for a hat trick as he gets it back to Renjiak. Renjiak back to Wilson. Wilson will fire. That's partially blocked and goes wide. Bujiak gets it down to Yeast. Renjiak holds it in. Wilson takes it away. Looking for some room, has to drop it off to Bruno instead. Bruno off to Renjiak. Renjiak a long-range shot. That's blocked in by a body. Ambach looks to clear. Renjiak holds it. Kent State on the run on this penalty kill as Wilson has it. Wilson trying to snake his way in on the left side. Can't. Tries to center the pass with the backhand. Blocked in by the skates of Ambach. As Stellenbott tries to chase it. Gets it out for Wilson, but that's blocked there by Corlew. Corlew takes possession of the puck and gets it all the way out into the neutral zone. Wilson has it now at his blue line. Drops it off for Renjiak. Kent State manages a line change just in time as Renjiak puts it back into their zone. And out comes Supek. Or sorry, out comes Sanchez. And Kent State kills that penalty. 4 for 5 on the night. Sanchez takes it the other way now. Dumps it in. Chases after his own dump. Meyer has it now. Meyer puts it on net. Redirection attempt by Volker goes just wide. Volker has it. Drops it off below the net for Sanchez. A good reverse hit there by Sanchez to get Boehm off of it. Sanchez tries to center it again, but Boehm blocks. Wilson briefly takes it the other way before losing his footing and forces it a drop-off for Grescia. Grescia out in front looking for Boehm. Boehm backhands. That's stopped by Coyne. Volker takes it the other way. Leads Magron. Magron with speed. Magron one-on-two. Can't manage the dangle, and Grescia takes that away. Now Okon going the other way. Steffel shadowing him. Okon tries to get a backhand on net. It goes across. Final minute of play here in regulation. Negron leaves it up ahead for Kantner. Kantner can't get there, so Negron has to take it back, but Renjiak takes it from him. Renjiak starts it up the other way. Crosses the red, then the blue. Stopped by Stellenbata. And he will shovel it out into neutral ice. Chasing it down there is Kantner. They're getting there first was Bujiak. Bujiak will elect to put it all the way down, but it's an icing. And with 27 seconds to go here in regulation, Kent State will get another offensive zone faceoff as Akron calls a timeout. Well, this has been some pretty high octane action here in the third period. No goals to show for it on either side, but good chances both ways as Hughes has held strong very well and Coyne has managed to get some good chances too. Kent State trying to interrupt the timeout there by Akron U. Trying their hardest anyways. Both teams discuss their options. Map out their game plans. Both goalies return to their net. Players return to the ice. Sanchez, Bloomquist, Meyer, Sippel, and Volkner. Out for the Flashes. Crowd is in it now. Face off one. Sippel puts it all the way back, and it gets stuck in Meyer's helmet. And by proxy, offside. 21.8 seconds. Kent State's hungry. They want this. They want a late goal, just like Akron got. Off the faceoff, it's one. Sanchez tries to spring himself. Can't. Wilson goes the other way with it now. Blocked up by Bloomquist. And Wilson can't get a clean opportunity. But he chases it all the way into Kent State's zone as Volker takes it the other way. Has Sanchez. Sanchez makes some room. Sanchez with a long-range slap shot. That's blocked by Boehm. Boehm's hurt as time will expire.
Don't get up!
Boehm is really stung up by that slap shot, but sacrificing the body to keep this 3-3. Looks like we will have extra time. We'll be going to a 5-minute overtime period. Kent State looking for the overtime winner in their senior night, hosting the Akron Zips, who they defeated last night as well. Well, as mentioned, this has been some really good back-and-forth hockey. Akron takes an early 2-0 lead. Kent State battles back, ties the game, takes the lead, and special teams playing crucial roles on both sides. Akron ties it up on a 5-on-3 with only 4 seconds to go in the period. And Kent State getting 2 consecutive power play goals to take the lead. Sounds like overtime is going to be 4-on-4 hockey. And Akron's captain Okon having a discussion with the referees. Not sure over what, but both teams holding their discussions. Akron U head coach has the pen and paper out. Kent State taking this opportunity to rest up, as is Akron. Multiple players, specifically the more prominent ones, resting on the bench. Not a whole lot of time here. It was just a 3-minute break, but trying to get as much rest as they possibly can before this ever-important overtime period starts. Goalie CJ Coyne seems unsure whether we'll be switching sides or not. All the Flashes are huddled around each other, discussing play with head coach Miles Radicevic. Overtime. We'll get started here shortly. Goalies will switch sides. CJ Coyne goes down the far end of the ice. Heading right is Hughes. You will have 3-on-3 overtime as Sanchez, Sipple, and Meyer are out there for Kent State. For Akron, we've got Ocon, Renziak, and Grescia. Meyer comes in, fights, and scores! It's Luke Meyer! Overtime winner! Only 15 seconds in! And Kent State takes their senior night! Great comeback completion there! Meyer creates his own room for himself, and again a shot against the grain! Just narrowly beating Hughes! 4-3, Golden Flashes! And the players surround each other and embrace. Well, the crowd is on their feet here. What an exciting win. Flashes fought back down 2-0 early in the first.